know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
Or poison. Okay, so I'm definitely not talking to Adam right now. I should have talked to Adam.
The police. It's the police.
Hey, hey. Pop the trunk, yeah. Open up. I sold my soul a good price out of sight. My hoe got talent right. Whole squad ran through that shit.
Maybe I should reset.
No. You're fine. God, what is happening? Is it because of the revolution in the game? But let me start off by saying, hey guys, how you doing? It's Nicolas Series here with another episode of Detroit Become Human, and things are getting deep, the plot's getting thicker, and with the last episode, we stopped a potential massacre from a deviant. If I was faster, it probably wouldn't have gotten that bad. I might have been able to bring it back intact, but I had to destroy it to save human lives. A conversation was had out after my gameplay yesterday that I let two other previous deviants go without incident, and this one I had to destroy. The other two times I could have captured the first one and I could have shot the second one. This one I did end up shooting, and I'm not entirely sure exactly how I still feel about that. And here Chloe is, like, I don't know, just feeling very confused about everything.
Did you know Detroit was on the Underground Railroad, a route for slaves escaping into Canada during the American Civil War?
I actually did not know that. But obviously we have already discussed the idea that this game very much parallels civil rights movement in America and everything else like that. Another thing I've been working on is my voice. Last video, I was using the webcam here as a recorder, and some comments were left behind saying that I muttered too much. So I'm going to try to clear up my voice. I'm using my headset mic today, so hopefully that actually works out a lot better. I'm going to lower down the game volume just a little bit. But with that being said, guys, let's get into it before, I don't know, Chloe just seems really... It's not there. Something's bothering her. We'll figure it out.
If a man has not discovered something he will die for, he's not fit to live. That's a quote from Martin Luther King.
Really?
I thought you'd like it.
Now, the question is, does she say that because for some way, shape, or form, she believed that I am black? Or is it something else? I don't know. Well, that is interesting. Something to definitely explore later. Something is definitely wrong with Chloe here. I can see it in her lip. Lower her left side. I see it on my right side. But something's wrong. Let's find out. Alright, a lot of snow on you, so you've been traveling for a bit. Hey, Alice. No, that's Kara. Alice is the girl with this guy. Find help. Check backyard. Help for what exactly? What's going on? I can't go over this. Okay, the game definitely... I was going to check the front door again, just to see if I could. I thought it was how scan the license plate. Oh, there is a man there.
For Rose? Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose.
Rose is the good girl.
What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you?
I said us.
Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
Obviously, the son, brother, maybe even husband.
Do you think we can trust him?
No problem, man. We have to.
We don't have a choice.
I very much. Oh, okay.
Okay.
I'm cold, Kara.
We'll get inside.
All right, androids don't get cold. So she has to be human, right? Like, we're definitely jumping back and forth here on the idea of whether Alice is an actual android or if she is indeed a human being. And the comment that Luther, we're starting to talk about.
Come in.
With the Pirate's Cove. It seemed like Luther has an understanding that she is.
What's your name?
Different.
Alice.
She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside.
And just don't have fevers, so yeah.
There's a spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
Rose and Adam. All right. He does not like this at all. I want to look at that book now. Okay, good. I don't have to, like, I can't. No. That closet door was open. I was very, very suspicious. Whenever I get Alice in bed, I'll snoop a little bit longer. Yeah, I don't really. Was he ejected? Put Alice to bed, okay.
Stop because of me. We've got to get across the border.
We'll get there, alright? We'll get there.
You need rest. Get a good night's sleep and we'll set off again tomorrow.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
In the famous words of Charles Xavier, people fear what they don't understand. That's out of fear.
Maybe they're just scared. People are always scared of what they don't know.
Why can't we just talk to each other? They'd see we're not bad.
Sincere.
I don't know. I really don't know.
I don't.
I don't know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
Or poison.
I'll get these washed and dried.
I need to see you eat. I need to see you eat. I was going to say this is good night, but I need to see you eat something.
You haven't had anything since we left. Promise me you'll try? I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
Get some sleep, and tomorrow you'll be stronger than me. I'll stay with her a while.
I'm not moving her to do these things. Okay. So the game's moving me because I constantly am in the way. Ask Rose about crossing the border. Alright, so there are certain things I've learned that even though it's not instructed for me to do or even an option, like for instance, whenever we were in the car at the Pirate's Rove level, looking at Alice was simply an act. So, that was counted at the end, as part of the flowchart, so. Alright, Snoop time. And from the looks of it, I don't actually have any access anywhere. I'm sorry, after all the things that have happened before, to not be cautious seems to be a very dumb move. I want to see if I can see the pictures. Because I want to make sure I can see both of them in the pictures. Nope, that's just a regular picture of, I think, Mary? A dog and a castle house or something. I'm not seeing any personal effects here. And that's my first warning sign right there.
I didn't get your name.
I'm Kara.
Damn it, I wanted to look at the book first.
This is my son, Adam.
Son, all right.
I'm Rose, but you know that already.
I do.
Come and have a seat, Kara. So are you going to tell me what a deviant's doing in the snow with a little girl?
Sincere.
Her father was beating her. When I saw what was happening, something snapped inside of me. All of a sudden, I felt like her life was more important than mine. I had to protect her. So we ran away.
I understand.
Because going to the cops would be ridiculous. The cops would help. Maybe Rose, thanks.
We're not the first ones to come here.
These past few weeks, we've seen more and more.
Adam is definitely feeling uncomfortable.
I don't know what's going on, but something's happening.
Why help?
Why are you helping us? Most humans hate androids.
My people were often made to feel their lives were worthless. Some survived, but only because they found others who helped them along the way.
We've heard you help androids cross the border.
Why is that a choice if it's the only choice I have?
The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's very risky. And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down.
We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border.
Yes, we do.
No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Well, technically we know where we need...
Rose, come quickly!
Who the hell's you? No. Yep, can't look at that book yet. Seriously, this woman just came out of nowhere. Everything's time sensitive.
What's going on?
At the very least, I don't know what is time sensitive.
She just shut down.
Oh, shit. If they have kill switches, that'd be interesting.
We escaped together.
We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border. I loved her. I loved her more than anything.
Andrew's at love.
What will I do without her?
RE9 will save us. Back of the wall. I'll take a look at it later. Show us the way.
Let them be.
You were supposed to be in bed. Luther had one job.
What are you doing? You should be resting.
I wasn't sleepy.
Come on.
It's okay.
Let's get out of here. Luther, seriously, one job, man. One job.
She didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
Yes. I'm fine.
I'm just pissed you had one job you couldn't do. Could I potentially go back? No.
We can't hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous.
Nothing happened today, Connors.
Do you know what happened if the police find them here? We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No! I won't back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines! They are alive!
I'm alive! You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk.
I'm not going to prison because you want to help these freaks.
That is enough, Adam! That's enough!
Don't mind him. Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away. But he's a fine boy.
Of course.
I'll go see about getting you across the border tonight, okay? You stay here. I won't be long.
Shit is literally about to hit the fan. World War III. Who would win it? Definitely something I can read later. Treat yourself. AX? I'm not sure what the AX... Number one, Andrew for home assistance. That's weird. There's no article for that one. It's just an ad. Oh. Well, that's that then. I have a feeling Luther will continue the story, and I want to take a look at that picture, so... Oh, blue blood. Good thing I looked. Adam's father. Should we try to talk to the boy? He just said I'm not doing it. Birds. Alright, so I honestly do believe talking to Adam would move things forward. So the question, should I talk to Luther? Or should I go through that door and talk to the others? Because there were a lot more than just, you know.
I hope Rose gets back soon.
Kara. There's something I need to tell you.
Now something happens.
It's about Alice.
I'm sorry, what now?
Not now, Luther.
Oh, jeez. Okay, so I'm definitely not talking to Adam right now. I should have talked to Adam.
The police. It's the police. What are we gonna do?
Okay. So, apparently talking to Adam is no longer an option. I had a feeling. God damn time. Okay, tell these two to hide.
They know we're here. We have to open the door.
Come on.
I knew this was gonna happen. I knew it.
Hurry, Luther. Take Alice and hide.
Upstairs.
Upstairs.
Come on, Alice.
41 seconds. Okay. Alice's clothes are here. Should that be a concern? Nope. Apparently it is not a concern. It's the blue blood things. Left. And why are you, like, utterly useless?
If they see you panicking, it's over. Do you want to get us into trouble? Do you want to get your mother into trouble? And keep calm and just do what I say.
All right, cool. That takes care of that. I have 26 seconds. Is that enough time to run upstairs? Okay, deal with problem. Oh, policeman. Some people might say the wording is virtually the same thing. Alright, let's do it. I think I got it all.
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Sure.
May I come in?
Of course.
Evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
Is anyone else in the house?
There's my daughter. She's asleep upstairs.
If they find Alice, that might just be fine. If she's human, and that might be the defining moment there. Coffee.
Do you have any androids here?
Yes!
No, there are no androids here.
I don't even remember if Lula took off his blue thing, his LED. I don't even know what's back there.
Thanks.
I thought something was gonna, like, just hit him over the head. Not suspicious at all. Good. Good. Good.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids, they...
He needs a rest. He's been working in the garden all day.
The garden?
Do you know anything about deviants? Have you seen any?
No. No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening. Is somebody else in the house?
It's nothing. The washing machine. It's an old model. It makes a terrible racket.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
Something doesn't seem right, right? Something just seems off. I'm not sure what all I missed, but I also realized last time I did forget to check the world stats there, and I might not myself go back and see what other people have done. 30% of people only checked on Alice. See, I knew that was going to be a big thing. Inside the house. Draw curtains. I don't know why people just didn't do that. Because it is one of the objectives. Alice approaches Mary. Wait, what? Follow Rose to laundry room. Alice approaches Mary. Who's Mary? I guess Mary must be the girl who died. Prevents Alice from seeing Mary. Okay, yeah. 48% of people prevented her from seeing Mary. Rose leaves to find help. Talk to Luther. Read magazine. There are two things I forgot. Oh, talking to Adam and checking the laundry room. That's why I wasn't able to do. I was able to see the family photo. Adam returns, obviously. Two things that happened that I couldn't even begin to guess. Apparently only 37% of people talked to Luther, so I'm guessing a lot of other people, other than read the magazine, went to the laundry room and talked to Adam, because that was an actual objective. Which is starting to seem weird. Actual objectives are starting to not be completed by time, because I get so preoccupied by looking at as much as I can that I just miss out on so many other things. It's like a balancing act that I'm not sure how well I'm doing on that. Hide the blue blood pouches, tell Alice and Luther to hide, shut the door to the laundry room, and hide the android clothes. Most people did that. So I'm guessing the closet, the thing that looks like curtains, alright, so in the kitchen, right next to the door, it looked like something that was like curtains, to like a shower. And the cat was looking there, and I'm like, I don't even remember that being there before. So Adam panics 100% of the time. opens door. I don't know, like, is there a way to talk to Adam and for him to not panic? Maybe? I reassure Adam rather than threaten Adam, because I'm pretty sure if I threatened Adam, he would have been like, they're all here. policeman questions Adam 90% of the time. Take that for what you will. 96%. Who doesn't make coffee for the cop? Who is it? Like, Would you like some coffee? Yes, I would like some coffee. And not make coffee. And not, just not make the coffee. Alright, so 54% people told Alice and Luther to go hide upstairs. And I guess the outcome to that would have been that he would have gone upstairs for or any of the other hiding places. I wonder if I would have said, yes, there are deviants here, because that was something I ran out of time on, and I pressed the button, like, a millisecond too late, and I just missed it just by hair. So, like, this is something that I just happened to have missed. Police food, okay? And policemen left. So the question, what would have happened if we didn't fool the policemen? What would have happened then? Because Rose came home almost immediately after that. So is it like a confrontation? Like, would he have gotten to another fist fight? And then Alice would have came in like, you gotta get out now. This is too much. Or maybe Alice would have gotten, not Alice, Rose, sorry. Rose came back immediately after that and confrontation could have happened and Rose could have been shot. Like, who? The possibilities are almost endless and I love it. So with that being said, geez, like, it's interesting that they use African Americans in this sense, obviously with the parallel of civil rights in the civil era, but to see that people are just people, and people will always be afraid of, if we help, if we do the right thing, we will go to jail. If we do the right thing, then trouble will come to us, to our doorstep, like the policeman. That could have honestly have been bad. And maybe this situation, even though Adam feels a little more, like, at the end, you definitely saw that he was a lot more confident and what have you, it really is more of a question of, like, has his idea kind of changed? Like, okay, I did the right thing because I didn't threaten him. I was like, hey, we got to keep calm. There's a little girl upstairs. We don't need to do any of that, like, you know, heroic stuff. You trying to be a hero. And honestly, in my mind, Adam reminds me of, if you guys have seen X2, I think it's called X-Men United, or something like that, whenever Iceman goes home to see his family and his little brother calls the cops. That's exactly the scene that came to my mind. I'm like, oh, that's what's gonna happen. Adam was the one who called the cops, and he's gonna be like, yeah, they're all up in here. Check that room, check upstairs, and this one over here. Like, I really kind of expected it to be just really horrible, but luckily he was able to kind of keep his cool. And I think the police officer seemed to just be like, okay, well, maybe he's just a young kid, and I'm a police officer, a man of authority, and he's just nervous around that, rather than the idea, like, oh, yeah, there's robots all over this joint. So, I honestly don't know. Like, drop what you think about the whole parallel, what you thought about Rose and Adam and that dynamic. Seeing the argument right there, that meant a lot to me, because I seem a lot more human than what I have been seeing throughout. Granted, I've seen a lot of flaws. Like, obviously, Hank has this drinking thing. Todd is an addict and a druggie. And it seems like they're kind of painting humans to be really horrible. And the only good human was Carl, and he died. With that little arc, I'm also kind of shocked that we don't ever experience Leo ever again. Like, Marcus doesn't go back like, hey, remember me? He just kind of, like, I don't know, hides his body, like, in the concrete floor or something. I don't know. But it just seems like they paint humans to be really, really kind of negative. And this is the kind of one scene that you kind of see a human helping out. And it seems sincere. And even that human is faced with a lot of adversity for helping out deviants. Because I'm starting to realize the term android cases the entire, I was going to say race, species, the robots, machines in general. But deviants are the ones that are self-aware. People think of it all as androids, but when you kind of get closer into it, you realize deviants are the ones that feel. Deviants are the ones that love, and deviants are the ones that we are more or less kind of rooting for. But it's me controlling most of these deviants. Well, at least Connor, Marcus, and Alice. And I've done my best to make them as non-violent as possible, because I know that's how I would behave in real life. Because I know that once you show a little bit of anger, once you show a little bit of retaliation, violence even, then people will instantly say, okay, that's all you are. You could have done a million. I had this conversation with somebody in college, when I attended college for criminal justice and computer information science. I had a conversation with my roommate at the time, and he was like, if Mother Teresa did one thing bad, like, not saying like literally, but she had to kill somebody for self-defense. Everybody would remember Mother Teresa for that one thing. Not the multiple other things that she did that was right, but the one thing that she did was bad, because that's just how people are. And so I usually try to only go that extra mile when I know that I need to, which is one of the reasons I felt really okay, decently okay about what happened last episode when it was the episode Public Enemy, where I had to shoot the other android. It was the idea, like, I had to do that. And then it wasn't like I shot the deviant and I kept the gun. I shot the deviant and returned the gun. I'm like, okay, I'm not the danger. I stopped the danger. I saw the situation. I had to stop it. And then, you know, and then here, move on. I'm not the next deviant here. You don't have to point your guns at me to understand. I did it only because the situation called for it, and the situation no one calls for it whenever I took care of it. So let's move on. Do not consider me the enemy. Because it's not about enemy. Like, even the speech where Marcus had during the broadcast, I did my best to kind of choose things that I believed was going to be right, nonviolent, and still move, progress deviant group of people forward, lack of better terms. But I've talked enough. Tell me what you guys think. Leave a like if you like this video, comment on what your thoughts are, and subscribe to see more content, hopefully tomorrow. And with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Later. Let's go.